This was a long movie. I actually took a nap in between it, though that may have more to do with my messed up sleeping pattern. Platoon, what can I say? If you're into war movies, this is a great one. If you're not, this is a war movie. May I just take a moment and say, wow, Charlie Sheen, sometime in between you being completely crazy and playing your crazy self in a show for many years called One and a Half Men, I forgot how great you are as an actor. The movie is set in the middle of the Vietnam War and it's focused on one, wait for it, platoon. I don't know why he made you wait for that, actually. On the surface, it's basically just that you get a glimpse into what goes on in a war. Some people make it out alive, others don't. And maybe it was just me, but the movie didn't make me feel anything for the people that died. If it's just me, I may have a serious mental problem. But the people who died, you're like, yeah, that makes sense. You play with fire and somebody with a rocket launcher is gonna blow your face off. I'm actually concerned right now. Did you care when somebody died in this movie? Maybe I've been watching too much Dexter lately. Here's the thing. I hate war. You may say it's a necessary evil, but I don't think evil is necessary. Ever. That made me think of Taylor Swift. So ever is now ruined for me. Yes, in some situations, if you don't shoot first, they will shoot you. But if you shoot them, their friends will be inspired to shoot you and more of your people. It becomes this never-ending cycle, but instead of staying in orbit, it just keeps getting worse and worse and worse as time goes by. I don't have a solution. I don't. I wish I did. I just know that war is part of the problem. Not of the solution. And you may be saying, you just don't understand, you stupid immigrant. Gosh, you're stupid. First of all, that's mean. And second of all, both my parents were in the military. Now only my dad is. I respect the people who put their life on the line for others, but as the movie showed so well, not everyone's there for noble reasons. What is a noble reason anyways? When somebody wants to go home and they're forced to be in the front lines and they die, is that dying for your country? Because I see it more like dying because you now belong to the military and you're an expendable asset to them. From secondhand knowledge, I know that most people who join the military don't do it to fight for their country. Actually, most of them are hoping they never have to fight. My parents did it because it provided free education for them and a better income to give me and my sister a better life. Many people join because in this economy, ironically, this is the most secure job they can get. It's not very hard to get into the military, especially if you want to be a soldier or something like that. I still respect when they put their life on the line because I wouldn't do that. If there is just one thing I took away from this movie, is that war doesn't just take away lives, it also takes away your soul of your shoe. Because a grenade will just melt that right off. No, I actually did mean soul. Soul, sister, let me hear your soul, sister, soul, sister, soul, sister.
See you later, crocodile.